Welcome to Theology for Everyone series. This is a Christian educational video series for church believers and theological students. Topic of today's video is theology. What is theology? This is a very common question confronted by all students in theological seminaries. For church believers, this term may appear alien due to their conception that theology is only meant for seminarians. On the other hand, theological students at least have a very basic understanding for this term, which is, theology comes from two Greek words, theos and logia. Theos means God, logia means word, discourse, account or reasoning. Therefore, theology means study of God. Question is this definition satisfactory? No, we need to have a detailed definition of this term. There are number of definitions in multitudinous theological books for the term theology. One among these definitions gave me a greater understanding of theology, which is found in the book Principles of Christian Theology, written by John Macquarie. Theology may be defined as a study which, through participation in and reflection upon a religious faith that seeks to express the content of the faith in clearest and most coherent language available. It seems very complicated, am I right? But it is not as complicated as it seems. Only understanding three key processes in this definition will help us to understand the whole. Number one, participation. Number two, reflection. Number three, expression. Let's understand these three words. First word is participation. First, we need to go through this first process called participation. This participation also has two parts. Participation in Christian faith, which means to become a believer. Participation in the community of believers, which is to become part of Christian church. First part is nothing but believing in Jesus Christ as our personal Savior, that He sacrificed Himself on the cross and rose on the third day in order to make atonement for our sins. Second is to be a part of Christian church and being in the fellowship of saints. Therefore, we are not just observers of this faith from outside, but participants of this faith. Second word is reflection. Reflection indicates our study and meditation on the Word of God. Bible, books, teachings, and preachings will help us to meditate on God's Word. We are called to reflect deeply about our faith and understand its meaning within the lives of the community. Once we participate in Christian faith, our next step is to meditate the Word of God and to have progressive understanding. Third word is expression. To express is to teach and preach to others what you have learned by participating in Christian faith and learning the Word of God. Most importantly, we need to teach and preach in the clearest and simplest way possible. Let me put it in simpler and shorter form. Firstly, you become a believer and live a Christian life. Secondly, you learn the Word of God in every possible means. And thirdly, you teach and preach what you have learned in simplest way possible. Now, this is the time to eliminate misconception about theology. First misconception. Theology is found in the big books of the library. Wrong. Theological books may help to understand the Word of God. But this learning is only a part of the process. Then where is theology? It is in your life. Yes. If theology is to become believer, to learn Word of God and share gospel to others, obviously theology is in your life. That is why we say doing theology, not studying theology. Second misconception. Theology is complicated and highly educated people can only understand it. Wrong again. Theology is very simple. If theology is not simplified, it is not at all theology. Remember the last note of the third process of doing theology. Theology may be defined as a study which, through participation in and reflection upon a religious faith, that seeks to express the content of the faith in clearest and most coherent language available. It is emphasized that you have to preach and teach in a way even illiterate people of your church should be able to understand. If your theology is not understandable by a grandma or a school kid, it is not theology at all. If any preacher or teacher says, "It is very complicated theological subject and you will not be able to understand," I really doubt their understanding of theology. Third misconception. Theology is only for Bible college students and ministers of God, not for the common believers. Once again wrong. As I mentioned before, theology is in our lives. But theology is not only in the lives of Bible college students and pastors. It is in the lives of everyone who is living a Christian life, meditating the Word of God and sharing gospel to others. If you are a Christian who meditates Word of God and share good news to others, theology is in your life. And you are also a theologian. Thank you. I hope this video is useful to you. Please share this video with your Christian friends. God bless you.